Very welcome to another Leica TS16 Total Station tutorial. And in today's video, I'm going to be creating points and I'm going to be importing and exporting data from the Total Station. So let's go. So I got that job here, sight edge control. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to press here and I'm going to create a new point. So I'm going to access here by view and edit data. And from here, I got a points, lines, images, scans, but I'm on the points now. So I'm gonna press new to create a new point here at TS001, but I'm gonna just maybe change it for P1, and I'm gonna type in some random coordinates here, just so we have it, and the random northing, and I got some height. Okay, what I can see now, I got the 4 decimals, and I don't like it. I never work like that. And I recommend you to keep it 3 decimals. And I probably went too fast to the regional settings. I keep the point here, but I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna show you how to set it. In the settings, I got a system here and the regional, I omitted quickly, but actually that's the place where we're gonna be changing the decimal numbers. And from 4, I'm gonna keep it 3. And that's how I recommend you to keep it all the time. 3, we work to the millimeters. That's well enough for us engineers. And I got the impression sometimes people working with 4, as they don't really know how to change it, or they never tried to change it and they just got used to it. So I'm gonna press OK now. And if I come back here and check my point, you're gonna see this will be 3 decimals now, coordinates. You can see that's how I wanna keep it. So that's how we create a point. And I'm gonna go now and I'm gonna import some data to the very same job. So I'm gonna go back here to the job. As you can see here, we got import, export data. So I'm gonna press import data here. ASCII data, that's going to be the first type of file I'm going to be bringing in. So I'm just going to press it here, and as you can see, ASCII from USB, that's exactly what I want. But we can choose here between SD card, USB, whatever we're using. Obviously we want to make sure and that's the right one. Basement TXT, that's exactly what I want to bring here. But just you can press here and choose between the jobs you want to bring. And another one is 2 job sight edge control, and that's exactly what I want to bring. But as you can see here, you can actually create a new job on import, so that's very useful as well. I'm actually going to use it in the next example. So by pressing FN here, we can change some settings. So depending on what data we're bringing in, we can actually change few things here. As you can see, it's a point, easting, northing, height, but that's how we typically keep it. And I wouldn't be changing anything here, as I said, unless we got some strange data coming in. So we want to make sure in the instrument everything going to be all right. So I'm just going to go back here, and what I'm going to do, I'm just going to press OK, and the job gonna be brought. So it's only 5 points, that's the control stations. No, I don't want to bring any more data in. And just to have a quickly look at what we got in here. So I'm gonna go view and edit data. As you can see, my points are here now. It's more than it was. And we can have a look at the 3D viewer, and that's how I like to work. I like to see the points. I work from the maps, from that viewer. That's our points here. Obviously we can navigate here, but I'm gonna tell a little bit more about navigating in the next video. So I'm going to go back now here, and I'm going to bring a DXF data, as that's what we're going to be mostly using when working with this instrument, with a robotic instrument really. So I'm going to go again, import data, and this time I'm going to pick up the DXF file, and from device USB stick, that's okay. Basement in millimeters, I'm going to put the basement like this. I'm going to press OK. Sight edge control, and I want to actually create a new job. So in this case I don't have that option, but I can click here, choose the job, and in here actually, instead of choosing the job, I can create a new job here now. So I just maybe call it basement as well, and as before I'm going to keep it as my job here, and I'm going to press here, I'm going to press store, and now I'm going to press OK. That's going to be choosing my job. So you can see 2 job, basement. But very important thing now, I want you actually to press FN here and change some settings. So as you can see, we got some prefixes here for the block, line, point, but my drawing is actually in meters, and it's very important here to make sure the units gonna be corresponding the drawing you're bringing in. So I got mine in meters, and I'm gonna change it in meters here. Obviously we can change these prefixes as well. So on point as P, line as L. And that's how I'm going to keep it, and I'm very happy with it. And I'm just going to press OK now, and that's how my job going to be brought now in meters, and all the prefixes going to be as I set them just here. We're going to have a look now. So OK, 91 points, all the stuff we don't want anymore here. And I'm going to go now to that basement, new created job by the way, and we're going to have a look at that data. So same as before, we got the points here. We can pick up the lines from here as well. Images, no images here, but we got that 3D viewer. And that's what I wanna have a look at. So that's the drawing I just brought. We got a few columns here. We got the walls as well. Just maybe quickly show you a few things. So that's the column. You can see I got that prefixes here, L5, L4, L3 for the lines, and that's how we're going to be looking. So that's how we're going to be bringing the data into the instrument. Obviously, we want to make sure the drawing is coordinated itself so we can actually jump and start working on it. So that's the different story, and I was covering it actually in one of my old videos. So I'm going to go back now and we're going to export some data. So it's very easy. I got to export data here, and the ASCII, I'm going to pick up the ASCII file here. You're going to ask me what memory I want to export the data. Obviously, I'm going to use a USB. I'm going to be exporting to USB, two folder data, that's fine, and basement TXT. And we got an example here, point, easting, northing, and height. Obviously, we can press FN here, check the settings or change the setting, how we want to bring it, what way we want the information to be exported, but I'm happy with it. And I'm going to press OK now. And report sheet BASA already exists on the USB. Okay, so I got the same information on the USB. Probably going to keep them different ways. So I'm going to press no. And I'm going to change that name maybe to basement. I'm going to put a double T just for now. And the export data is complete. And that's what we got. And in case of bringing DXF data, that's going to be exactly the same. I'm just going to press here, export data, DXF. And same here, I'm going to take it to the USB. We got folder data. That's how I'm going to keep it. Site and control. Maybe I'm just going to change a little bit. Okay, that's fine. Just to export it. I'm going to press OK here. Export of data complete. Okay. And that's all we need. And that's exactly how we're going to be exporting the data, our as-builds, our surveys. We're going to be bringing them later to the CAD and we're going to be working with the data. So guys, that will be all in today's video. In the next one, I'm going to be talking more about navigating that map, 3D viewer, and also we're going to have a look at the resection. So if you like the video, please don't forget to leave the thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel, as there are going to be more coming. So if you're interested in learning, if you want to know more about surveying and setting out in construction, that's the right place for you. And I really invite you to join the community and subscribe to the channel.